गुड इवनिंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू बेटा। सो इज इट ऑडिबल एंड विजिबल? So, yesterday I have given you the whole flow chart for the coverage of nuclear technology, and we have started with the nuclear energy, and there is two types of nuclear energy. You know that nuclear fission and nuclear fusion, and I started with the nuclear fission, and in the nuclear fission I said that when a neutron is bombarded on a large unstable nuclei, then it disintegrated into two smaller nuclei, and the resultant mass defect converted into high energy along with three neutrons. This is your nuclear fission I talked about, and thereafter many ways I tried to make you to understand, and then I said it should be only neutron, or it should be thermal neutron. Then I make you to understand what is thermal neutron means. It's not, I said, that fast neutron going to, I said, attached with the large nuclei and unstable to disintegrate, but there is a requirement of, I said, that slow speed, and that slow speed neutron is known as thermal neutron, and this slow speed neutron is made with the help of, you know, that I said moderator, and moderator can be of water, it can be heavy water, it can be a graphite. So we have been able to see what is moderator. So under the component of nuclear reactor we have been able to see there is moderator, and what is the job of moderator? I said that it is slowing the speed of neutron, slowing the speed of neutron, and especially which are, I said that it is, I said water, heavy water, graphite. These are the things that we have been able to see, and then I said there is a coolant. And coolant is, I said that it is in a again which can absorb the heat generated into the, I said, in the nuclear chamber, heat generated to be absorbed. So it is an absorption of heat. It is an absorption of heat generated in nuclear chamber, and that I said that, yes, again, what could be water is an, I said that good coolant, and heavy water is also in a good coolant, and we can say that there is in a water and heavy water, and at the same time I said that some gases are also there. Gases are there who can be I said that absorb the heat, and better to say that it is carbon dioxide. It is one of the gas which can absorb the heat also, and thereafter we can be able to see there is an, I said that liquid sodium metal. So sodium metal in the liquid form, it also absorb the heat. So these are the important coolant, always remember which are, and those who absorb the heat simply and transmit it somewhere else. So it is in a water, heavy water, gases and liquid sodium metal. It is in our nuclear reactor it lies. Another we have been able to see, like I said, that there is in a control rod, And control rod is like I said that it is a I said that absorption of neutron. If you are putting little bit control rod within the nuclear chamber, then it will, I said that one out of three neutron, one neutron absorbed, and thereafter putting more than two neutron and one neutron means it is controlling the chain reaction or by absorbing the neutron, controlling the chain reaction or nuclear fission, controlling the nuclear fission by controlling nuclear fission, controlling nuclear fission by, I said that absorbing neutron. Means if you are able to absorb the neutron, it depends upon what? Means at the same time it can stop the nuclear reaction. It also it can, if you are putting controlling rod more inside, it can stop completely chain reaction. So I can say that a control rod can be also, like I said that it can, if we put control rod completely inside nuclear chamber, then it will stop nuclear fission. Or so it is, its a job is, I said that, and the major one, you know that indium, cadmium, I said that these are, I said major, I said boron, you can see like here it is, you can boron, silver, indium, cadmium, you can see like this one, boron, indium, silver, and I can say that it is boron, silver, indium, cadmium. But if I say that boron and I said that cadmium are more utilized, you must remember that boron and cadmium, as an I said that control rod inside the nuclear chamber, it is more utilized, boron. Otherwise how you can remember for long time, you know that I know all of you are not married, and but those who are married, her wife you can say like it is bossy, you can make it like bossy. So the any Indian who I said that her wife is considered as in a not I said wife, but better to say bossy, only make. So I am just making it to what I said, laugh and remember for a long time. So who, and there is in a bossy, and she is Indian also, bossy Indian, and she is controlling, I said that she is controlling the house, and then also the husband, I said that bossy, B for boron, C for silver, and Indian, it is indium, and you can also say that cadmium, she is always ready to, I said that cut or miss anything you can remember, she is ready to bite, miss, cut, kaatne ke liye ready rehti hai, cadmium, you can remember this way, cadmium. So this is what I said that boron, silicon, indium and cadmium are, I said that these are control rods which is controlling the nuclear fission in the nuclear power plant, and mostly boron and cadmium is utilized, that we have seen. And another I said another we have been able to see like there is in a shielding means it is in a 2.25 meter thick concrete wall of nuclear reactor. So nuclear reactor has, I said that 2 to 2.25, you can understand that 1 meter is very long, and after that 2 to 2.25, this kind of thick concrete wall is, I said that, made to stop the, I said radiation to go out into the I said the nearby atmosphere. So India is very well made that any kind of leakage cannot happen. So if this shielding will be there, then leakage will not happen. So there is a shielding. So we have been able to see there is an first one moderator, then there is a coolant, and there is a control rod, all are in the nuclear chamber, thereafter shielding, and then we have to see also the two more, and these two more are turbine, and a turbine is a fan which started moving by the steam, perhaps you remember, and here it is, then the generator. And turbine, you know that when the steam, when the coolant is coming in the form of steam, then they used to make the turbine to move. And then turbine means, I said that converting heat energy into mechanical energy. Turbine is what I said that converting heat energy into mechanical energy. And generator means, I said that when this turbine, this fan like structure started moving, so this fan like structure is attached with an armature, better to say generator, then the generator also started moving. If the fan turbine is moving, then the generator, and then that mechanical energy, that moving thing is able to produce electricity. The generator is converting, it is converting mechanical energy into, electrical energy. So these are the six components, we can say that moderator, control rod, shielding, coolant, turbine, generator. These are the six components are there, which is, I said, that nuclear reactor has. Perhaps everyone is must be clear about all those six aspects. Clear? These six aspects must be clear to you, that it is moderator, it is, I said, that slowing the speed of neutron, and then control rod, it is made for, I said, that absorption of neutron, and the shielding, I said, that radiation cannot go out, it is shielding the radiation. Coolant means absorbing the heat and that convert into steam or something like this, that it is making the turbine to move, and when the turbine started moving means converting heat into mechanical energy, and thereafter generator. This is the way, and perhaps you remember that there is discussed with you that there is, I said, this is your nuclear chamber. In this one there is a nuclear rod, and the nuclear rod is there, and also in the below there is a coolant, there is a moderator, and these small rods are there, it is, I said, that control rod, and above it is, I said, that coolant. And then now that it is heat energy started producing, and that heat energy, and then you know that it is a boiling water reactor. In this one moderator is water, and coolant is also water. Moderator and coolant both are water. So what happened below, there is a water that is helping in reducing the speed of neutron, thermal neutron making it, and upper one heat generated is carried by this pipe into the form of steam. And when it is going into the steam, this is in a turbine, and the turbine started, I said, that what? Moving. This steam is making the turbine to move, and thereafter turbine is connected with the generator, and then it starts electricity producing. Then the steam comes into a condenser. Here this steam, which is the steam which is coming from the turbine, it started coming into in a particular chamber that is in a condenser. And in this condenser, that the steam converted into water because its temperature is low. And then this converted into water, and again this water coming into the main chamber. So again in the nuclear chamber, this water is again returning back. So this is the way, there are the in the simplest form, I said that this is one of the boiling water reactor. I said the nuclear reactor is this, and then world main, there is around 80% of nuclear reactor is this kind of reactor, boiling water reactor, but India doesn't have any boiling water reactor. So you can be able to see, like I said, that what is boiling water reactor. Perhaps it is clear. So now, perhaps it is clear to all of you. It is, I said that in this is in a chamber, and in this one it is filled with this region is filled with the lower section is filled with the moderator, upper section is coolant, and both are water. And here it is this one is control, and this one is, I said, that control rod, and that is you know that controlling the, by absorbing the neutron it is controlling the nuclear fission. And here the this coolant is coming through this, and this after in the heating of this nuclear fission, the heat generated, and the heat generated is absorbed by the coolant, and that is water, and it is coming, and it is making the turbine to move. When the turbine starts moving, then what happened? Generator started what producing electricity, and then this way we are able to get electricity in the different rural or urban regions. And this steam is again coming back into the condenser, and thereafter this condenser is converting steam or water vapor, steam or water vapor into the water, and again this water coming into this nuclear chamber. So this way always this water is acting as a moderator as well as a coolant. That it is, perhaps it is clear to you. Yes, there will be a little this water must have some amount of nuclear radioactive mineral must be, and therefore it can cause a little bit corrosion that can cause, but this water is not going anywhere. It this steam is coming into the turbine, thereafter it is coming into this condenser, and in the condenser this steam converted into water. But there is that's why I said that this turbine get contaminated by the radioactive minerals, that is affecting this turbine. So slowly and slowly this turbine get, I said, that rust out, and we have to change the turbine after few years. So this water is contaminated. So perhaps all the four components are clear to you. UPSC can ask, so what are the important components which help in what is nuclear fission, and discuss the different types of it. The question can be like I said, what is nuclear fission, and discuss different important components required in nuclear reactor. Clear? So you have to explain it. Okay, this is this one, this is this one, it is in a moderator, it is in a coolant, it is in, I said, that controlling rod, and also make them to what I said, that explain it very beautifully in your words, and then how do it is going on. So this is the way that it is a nuclear reactor is producing electricity. So we have been able to see, like I said, that what are the components of nuclear reactors we have seen, and perhaps this question is, I said, that clear to you. My next point that is, I said thereafter yesterday, one thing I have also discussed with you, there is a controlled nuclear fission and uncontrolled nuclear fission. So controlled nuclear fission, you can be able to say like it is I said nuclear reactor where the energy is being produced for the peaceful purpose of the any country, because that energy will help in the socio economic development of that country. And another point we can say that uncontrolled nuclear fission, where there is an I said that neutron is coming out in every amount, and this reaction is continued like a chain reaction, and we can say that it is, I said, that atomic bomb. Uncontrolled nuclear fission is atomic bomb. And yesterday we have also seen what is the fissionable material, that I said fissionable material, those who after the bomb material, those who after the bombardment of neutron, I said that disintegrated into smaller nuclei and with the energy, that is a fissionable material. And fertile material are those who does not, I said that, who does not disintegrate into smaller nuclei after the neutron bombarded, but those material can be converted into fissionable material through the process of transmutation. So we have seen that there is a fissionable material like uranium-233, uranium-235. These are two, and thereafter plutonium-239 and plutonium-241 is fissionable material. But the fertile materials are like uranium-238. Remember that. If you remember that, the coming part of this class you will enjoy more. And I said that uranium-238 and I said thorium-232, they are, I said, fertile material. But uranium-238 can be transmutation, can be done into the, I said, plutonium-239 by the one neutron and two beta decay. Similarly, thorium-232, perhaps it is clear to all of you, yesterday I have discussed in detail, and thorium-232 can be converted into, I said, uranium-233. So that is, I said that yesterday we have seen like this. And another that points that we have to see, what is now, next one is nuclear fuel cycle. After that, after doing this nuclear fuel cycle, we'll go for the distribution of nuclear energy, nuclear reactor in India and all. Then I'll come for the nuclear reactors types and all, and you'll enjoy more. So nuclear fuel cycle. Nuclear fuel cycle consists of, and when I'm writing some facts, na, so you just try to revise it and so that you can remember. I said that it is mining. Mining. Mining, myelin, enrichment, then reprocessing, and then another that we can say that fuel fabrication. Mining, myelin, enrichment, and it is very much important, it is, everything is important. And thereafter reprocessing and then fuel fabrication. So these are the five things it is coming under the nuclear fuel cycle. Clear? So mining, myelin. Before going ahead, I'll ask a question based on prelims. And I said that which of the statements are correct regarding nuclear reactor. First, I said that option, I said, and you know that nuclear reactor is based on controlled nuclear fission, nuclear reactor is based on controlled nuclear fission. Second statement, control rod of nuclear reactor, help in reducing the speed of neutron. Control rod of nuclear reactor help in reducing the speed of neutron. Third, I said coolant in nuclear reactor exchange heat. coolant in nuclear reactor, coolant in nuclear reactor exchange heat. So I have said that first statement I said which of the what the question it is, which of the statements are correct regarding nuclear reactor. I said that nuclear reactor is based on controlled nuclear fission, first statement. Second statement, controlled rod of nuclear reactor help in reducing the speed of neutron. Again I said that controlled rod of nuclear reactor helps in reducing the speed of neutron. And the third statement I said that coolant in nuclear reactor exchange heat. So now tell me which of the statements are correct, which of the statements are correct. I said first statement, nuclear reactor is based on controlled nuclear fission. Second statement, control rod of nuclear reactor help in reducing the speed of neutron. And then third statement, I said coolant in nuclear reactor exchange heat. Be careful in answering, beta. Read the statement very carefully. Read the statement very carefully, beta. Read the statement, everyone, very carefully. First statement, I said that nuclear reactor is based on controlled nuclear fission. Nuclear reactor is based on controlled nuclear fission. Second statement, control rod of nuclear reactor help in reducing the speed of neutron. Help in reducing the speed of neutron. Third statement, coolant in nuclear reactor exchange heat. Yes, everyone. I said which of the statements are correct. Be fast in answering, beta, everyone. Read the statement carefully. So I said that some of you, most of you, I said that most of you are able to make a correct option, and let us say that which are correct. And if I say nuclear reactor is based on controlled fission, that is correct, and uncontrolled is atomic bomb. Uncontrolled is atomic bomb. Second statement, control rod of nuclear reactor help in reducing the speed of neutron. This is wrong, because control rod absorb the neutrons. Okay, it is trying to eliminate the neutron from the out of the chamber. It is, I said that absorb the neutron. Third statement is, I said that coolant in nuclear reactor is exchange heat, means it is correct. It is taking the heat from the nuclear chamber and taking it to the turbine. It is an exchange the heat. May suppose if I am eating, I am also taking the heat, and therefore my body is running on, and after certain period that heat is, I said, that gone after working. So may, if I am taking the heat from the food, then after that slowly and slowly from my body it will release into the atmosphere. So heat never be at one point, it will always move from one point to another. So the similar way, the heat, the coolant has taken the heat by absorbing the heat from the nuclear chamber, thereafter they have given this this heat in the form of steam. Heat is in the form of steam. Where the heat is there? Water converted into steam, and that water vapor or steam helps in moving faster, and then turbine is running. So it is an exchanging the heat. Coolant is exchanging. The option number 1 and 3 are, so I said that beta, therefore I said that now, even if you have understood the concept, I said that even if you have understood the concept, if thereafter students used to make a mistake. So always I said that keep on revising the notes so that you should not make mistakes. Understood? That is known as big mistakes, or that is you know and make a mistake. When you know and make a mistake, it is known as blunder. But you don't know and make a mistake, that is it is understood that you don't know, therefore you are making mistake. But if we know and making a mistake, it is the biggest mistake, or can we can say like blunder. So please, the UPSC is trying to play with your, I said that mind setup, and that mind setup to be prepared by you by reading the same facts and contents and the concept again and again, so that your content can be stronger. Clear? So anyone can make this exam easier and to clear. So I said that 1 and 3 are, I said that correct, everyone is okay. So please, I said that remember everything like the next one. We have to see, like I said that myelin. If I am talking about, I said that nuclear fuel cycle. Next we are coming, I have given the answer, everyone. 1 and 3 is correct, clear? And I think most of you are able to write better answer, but some of you are, I said that some 3-4 students, maybe 5 students around, those who have made mistake. So they know that what is the correct answer, but there is an, I said that confusion, which is, I said that understanding the statement. So next one, it is nuclear fuel cycle. I know that the nuclear fuels are like uranium and all. So first it is about mining. Means I said that mining is already, it is clear that it is taking out, I said that uranium from the mining areas. So it is an excavation. You can be able to say that it is an excavation. So here you can be, the mining area already, you know that. So it is in a mining. I said that there is in a mining, myelin, enrichment, reprocessing and fuel fabrication. These are the 5 R, I said that, which is considered as, I said that, a nuclear fuel cycle. Mining already know what I said, that removal of or extraction of uranium from the mining. Uranium from the mine. Clear? Extraction of uranium from mine. But if it is talking about myelin, but when you have taken out uranium from the, when you have taken out uranium from I can say like mining area, so thereafter you have to crushing of uranium, and better to say like I said that what is myelin, crushing uranium into powder. And with the help of this, it is an uranium powder, and that we are making it, and that we are making it, I said that yellow cake. That is, I said that it is in a kind of what brick kind of structure that has been given, crushing uranium into powder and converting into yellow cake. And here it is, I said that yellow cake. So and that is the that yellow cake can be utilized in the I said that further processing. Further processing, I said that next one it is about I said enrichment. Enrichment. I said that beta exchanging. This is the simple dot simple idea. From the chamber, whatever not from the control, it is. I said that coolant does job the heat from the uranium rod. Beta, there is no heat from the uranium rod. That heat has been released from the uranium rod, and that is coming into the water. Exchange means what? From one point to another point. Exchange means from one point to another point. So heat is generated where? Heat is generated in the nuclear chamber. And thereafter that has been moving by the hot water and it is moved towards the turbine and that is in the form of steam. It has been so that that energy of steam, that energy of the steam, the heat is utilized in converting into mechanical energy. So what is the meaning of it? I have said that energy can neither be created nor destroyed, but it can be from one form to another form. So you have been this energy has been exchanged from I said that nuclear chamber to the turbine it is. So that's what it is completing. So mining is clear. I said that it is mining of uranium. Mining, MILLING, mining is crushing the uranium and crushing the uranium into powder form and converting into yellow cake. This is your mining. Simply a yellow cake, it is like you know that making in some brick structure like this yellow cake. So these are the two things must be clear. Thereafter I am going for enrichment. And then what is enrichment? So that when we mine, and then we, I said that convert into yellow cake. So in this yellow cake, that uranium that we have got it from nature. So here the we have a natural uranium. We have a natural uranium that it is in the form of yellow cake finding. This is mining. This is mining. We are doing mining. Then this is what I said that mining. Now the next it is in this. There is an in this uranium, this is a natural uranium in the form of yellow cake and it will have 99.3% where it is uranium 238 and 99.3% I have said that and only I said that point only 0.7% 0.7% is uranium 235. Uranium 235. So, natural uranium is I said that. So this uranium 235 is in a, I said that fissionable means it is only giving energy. It is only giving energy because it is fissionable. So here it is we this uranium 235 will be utilized for producing energy but it is like uranium 238 you can't utilize it if you're bombarding neutron if you are bombarding neutron then it will not be giving energy it will not I said that disintegrate into smaller nuclei and giving large amount of energy so uranium 238 is like I said that waste into the chamber because not producing energy it is like a waste I said that it's like a waste because not producing, I said that energy. It's like a waste because I said that not producing energy. And you can be remember that 99.3%, this much of 99.3%, this much of, I said that uranium-238 and uranium-235, which is going to give energy only 0.7%, that you can say that. Only very, very less amount of uranium-235 available in the uranium ore when we have extracted. So, only very few amount, so that you can remember that it is, this is your, I said that we are going to see enrichment, means we have to enrich. It means we have to enrich. Enrich means making richness, making more in amount with something. I said, suppose one in the story form, suppose I have an, uranium, I have an one filter. Suppose I have an filter. Suppose I am making to understand. I have an filter in this filter. In this filter, I said that uranium-238 and uranium-235. And I started filtering, and here it is. First, there it is, only 0.7% is what I said that uranium-235. And I started filtering, and then what happened? I am able to get, and then after filtering out, it comes into the another chamber, and here it is uranium-235, and here it is uranium-238. But this time, percentage of uranium-238 become around 1% to 3%. Uranium-235. So, I said that after filtering, and again I said that this I started again filtering, more filtration. So, here we are, I said that filtration I have done, and the filtration has been given us 1% to 3% of uranium-235. Earlier in the natural uranium only we have, 0.7% of uranium-235 that we can utilize. But now, I started enriching means how to increase uranium-235, percentage of uranium-235. So, we started filtering out, and then uranium-235 become 1% to 3%. Now, the next point I said that, again we have, uranium, and here we have uranium-238, and here it is uranium-235, and you know that uranium-235 is 0.7%. And I said that filtering, and this time I did filtration more and more, filtration, one after another filtration, and we have been able to get uranium-235. And there is an uranium-235, and here it is uranium-238. So now uranium-235 became, after the filtration, it is 3% to 20% uranium-235. Means making the uranium-235% is more. That is enrichment, making enrichment. Uranium-235 to be what I said, that increase its percentage. So, I said that uranium-235 become 3% to 20%, and then I said that again we have taken the uranium, there is uranium-238 and uranium-235, and I keep on filtering, and then filtration is very high number, and we got here it is 0.7% uranium-235, but here after the several process of filtration, we are able to get around 20 to 80% of uranium-235. बेटा छननी जानते होगे ना, फिल्ट्रेशन, फिल्ट्रेशन समझते हो? जस्ट अंडरस्टैंड इन द फॉर्म ऑफ फिल्ट्रेशन, समथिंग आई एम व्हाट फिल्टरिंग. बेटा आई टेल यू लाइक अंटिल इफ आई सेड दैट यूरेनियम 238 कैन बी ट्रांसम्यूट इन टू वॉट प्लूटोनियम 239 इफ आई डोंट हैव द टेक्नोलॉजी देन इट्स लाइक एन अ वेस्ट. Here it is, if I don't have technology to transmutation, this transmutation is not a small process. If I don't have the technology, if I don't have this much of energy to transmute it, then it is like a waste. Several things is waste until unless it is not utilized. Clear? So therefore, it is like now, this is not going to be, it is making into energy. Suppose many uranium, if I am making uranium into the chamber, so only 0.7% of uranium 235 will give energy, and then rest 99.3% of uranium 238 will not give energy. What does it mean? Yadi maine, if I have, I said that someone into the race, and only one portion win, and the 99% did not win. What does it mean? One is only I said that utilizable 99, or I said that not able to what produce any result. Yes or not? So I said it is like a waste, that I can say right now, but I can convert into, transmute into any other thing. Just wait for this. Abhi, it's like a waste. You know that what is the meaning of it. If the sir has said waste, you should say, okay, what is the meaning of waste? Perhaps you do not know what is the waste. If it is not in your use, it is a waste. Perhaps anybody is a technology. Suppose I have coal. The coal and the iron ore, suppose I don't have the technology to make steel, then iron ore is like a waste for me. When I'll have a technology to convert iron ore into steel, then it will be become usable for me. So what is the definition of waste? Just think over it. Whatever the word comes, beta, this is the exam where you should see that even is very general words should have better none to you how to utilize it. If you are not able to utilize it, you will be caught. This examination is not a hard examination. It is, I said that it is made up of very basic to the hard level of kind of it. Abhi filhal to main abhi beta enrichment hi abhi yahi bata raha hun, that it is, I said that I have to increase the percentage of, I am saying that enrichment means increase the percentage of uranium 235. This is the most important. I said enrichment. I have to make you, I am just, when I am teaching you science and tech, I am increasing your knowledge, so I am enriching you. I am enriching you. Slowly and slowly, you are enriching yourself with the knowledge that if I am giving and if you are understanding, then it is an enrichment. And again, sometimes you don't understand. Again, I am explaining it. So slowly and slowly, you enrich yourself. Means the knowledge is increasing. So filhal, that much you can understand that enrichment, it is, I said that it is an increasing the percentage of, that's not an easy thing, beta. India is not doing this, but I'll tell you why India is not doing this, and all the things, technological aspects, everything I'll tell you. So I said that enjoy karo na yaar. Sir, bade asan language, I'm using very easy language instead of bookish language, you just think. I have an uranium 238, uranium 235. I start filtering, then it become 1% to 3%. Then I start filtering. Again, I have an uranium 238 and uranium 235. This time I filtered more number of times filtered. I said that I got uranium 235 increased its percentage from 3 to 20%. And then now, this time I filtered uranium, natural uranium. This is, I said that what? This combination is known as a natural uranium, and natural uranium has uranium 235 is 0.7% and uranium 238 is 99.3%. So I have done filtration several time. And then it become 20 to 80% uranium 235. So we can be able to see, like I said, the enrichment means means increasing the percentage of uranium 235. Enrichment means increasing the percentage of uranium 235, and there are three types. One, it is, I said that slightly enriched uranium, SEU, and their percentage is 1% to 3%. Uranium 235 will be 1% to 3%. There is, I said that second one is low enriched uranium, LEU, that we can say that 3 to 20% uranium 235. And third, I said that highly enriched uranium, that I said that HEU, and here 20 to 80% uranium 235. Listen me, beta, I'll tell you everything. Just I'm telling you in the form of story. I'll tell you everything. Have patience. What is the meaning of my question is, what is the meaning of fissionable, everyone? Who can fissionable material can give energy, large amount of energy, or fertile material can give? Let me tell you, 1 gram of uranium will give some energy which is equivalent to, I said that 1,000 ton of coal. Sorry, 1 kg. 1 kg of uranium is giving some energy, and that is equivalent to 1,000 ton of coal. Coal is not fissionable, sodium is not fissionable, and then I said that any other minerals are not fissionable, but here it is fissionable, and it is giving large amount of energy. This is the uniqueness, what we are doing since yesterday. I said that it is the one who only a neutron, we can't see the neutron in the chamber. There will be millions of neutrons. There is not only one neutrons in this nuclear chamber that will come and strike with the uranium, unstable uranium 235, and they will disintegrate into barium and krypton and releasing electron energy. Mega what I have said, mega electron volt. It means very high energy. It is a large amount of energy it will release. This is the uniqueness of I said uranium. You should ask this question yesterday, because I have said that it is, I said, releasing, I have word I have given, releasing high amount of energy. And this is the high amount of energy, 1 kg of uranium, that if it is releasing the energy, that will be equivalent to 1,000 ton of coal. Those who are fissionable, they give large amount of energy. Simple. Perhaps this question is clear to a student who is not able to understand what is the uniqueness of fissionable material. Uranium, you can't take it in your hand. It is releasing some amount. It is itself decaying out. It is unstable. And when the neutron bombarded, it is, I said, that it blasts everything, releasing large amount of energy. So you can be able to see, like I said, that this is the meaning why it is unique. my job is to first making you to understand better. In the book, if you'll go na, there will be enrichment means increasing the percentage of uranium 235. Okay, this is SEU, this one, LEU, this one, HEU, this one. And I am trying to say that what I am getting from the on the three pages I try to make the through the figures. Abhi main bataunga, more process I will tell you. Abhi, now I have to utilize gravitational process and the centrifugal process. So when the centrifugal process, if I am talking about diffusion process, if I am talking about, then you will understand, okay sir, now it is okay. So if you are not waiting and you started asking, just wait. If perhaps it is clear now, okay, if the uranium 235 is 1, 2, 3 portion, it is known as sulfuritely. So if we are extracting uranium from the mine and if I am getting it is in the form of yellow cake, so it has only, I said, that 0.7% uranium, and that is not sufficient to produce energy. I should have more uranium 235. Kya 0.7% will be more, suppose, and what is the meaning of 0.7%? Very small amount. If you are putting into nuclear reactor, then it will produce some energy and then time phase, and thereafter nuclear reaction production of energy will stop. Production of energy will stop because there is a very small amount, 0.7%. So what it is, if I'll increase the uranium to the 235%, suppose in what is the meaning of it, if I say that generally, what is the meaning of it? Here, if it is 1000 kg uranium, then you can be able to say that 99.3% means, I said that out of 1000 kg, 993 kg will be uranium 238, and only 7 kg will be uranium 235. Are you able to see the difference? Will it be sufficient? The mass of uranium 235 should increase. The mass, or you can say the percentage. When the percentage will increase, its mass will increase. Yesterday I taught, you know, fissionable and fertile. Fissionable will give the energy. So after the bombardment of neutron, it will disintegrate and give energy. And now if I am saying that 1% to 2%, if there is an, I said that 1000 kg, and if I am talking about 1%, the 1% means what? 1% to 2, 3% means 10 kg to 30 kg will be uranium 235. And if I am talking about 3% to 20%, so out of 1000 kg, 3%. 1000 ka 1% kya hoga? 10. 3% will be what? 30 kg, and 20% will be what? I said that. 20%, yes, tell me. 200 kg. So out of 1000 kg, this much of uranium 235 is increasing. So if the mass of uranium 235 in the nuclear chamber will be more, they will release more and more energy can be there. So I should have a better, I said that mass. So just I have given you, enrichment means increasing the percentage, and there are the three types of, I said that, enrichment: slightly enriched uranium, low enriched uranium, highly enriched uranium. And 1, 2, 3% uranium 235 is slightly enriched uranium. In any uranium rod, if I said that uranium 235 is 3 to 20%, it is known as low enriched uranium. And if it is, I said that uranium 235 in the nuclear rod, if I said that it is 20 to 80%, it is known as highly enriched uranium. Getting it? My question is, now tell me which enriched uranium will help in making atomic bomb. My question is, which enriched uranium out of those three which enriched uranium, my question is, which enriched uranium will help in making atomic bomb? Which out of those three types of enriched uranium, which can be utilized for making atomic bomb? They should have a less enriched uranium, very high enriched uranium. You just tell me your mind. I am creating your understanding, beta. I am trying to create your understanding so that you should not depend on me. Whenever something comes, you should be ready to answer. My question is, which uranium can be utilized in making atomic bomb? Everyone answer. I will make you to think like those who are preparing since 3 years, beta. My teaching will be always like that, where you will, those who are preparing since long, you will be equivalent to that, and even I said that you can be better than those students. I am trying to put out towards the gate of civil services and then UPSC. I don't want that you should be the crowds of the lakhs of the students. There are lakhs of students preparing and every year not able to clear the prelims. Just answer, I have given all kind of thought. Answer me, which enriched uranium will be utilized in So everyone answered, perhaps you understand what I am trying to say. My next question is, listen to me very carefully. In university, if I have to do research, in medical, if I have to do some cancer treatment, in university, if I have to do some education for the education or research, in university, if I am doing some research, and in medical, that cancer treatment and other purposes, which enriched uranium will utilize in the research? And listen me very carefully, you should think of, if in a university there is a research is there, lab is there, which enriched uranium will be utilized? My next question to all of you, please answer that question now. In the research of university, there will be, which enriched uranium will be utilized in the research and in your medical treatment related to cancer and any such diseases? Which enriched uranium will be utilized? In the research of any university, and medical treatment, which will be utilized? You are itself, I don't teach, I didn't teach, what is the use of SEU, what is the use of LEU, what is the use of HEU, you itself started understanding. I am making you to grow like that. Now my next question is, which enriched uranium will be utilized in nuclear power plant? My next question is, everyone is correct, beta, everyone is going correct. Very good, all of you are very good. All of you are very good. Now my next question is, which enriched uranium it lies in nuclear power plant or nuclear reactor? Tell me which enriched uranium will be utilized in our nuclear reactor. Everyone is going right. Research and education, SEU. Atomic bomb, HEU. Now my next question is, which enriched uranium will be utilized in nuclear power plant? There is no MEU, beta. There is a nuclear power plant or nuclear reactor, both are same. So please give me time. It's a request from my side that please give me time. I'll help you to go there where you need. I know that what is your need and what is the need of UPSC, though, so that you should be at what kind of student. Yes, low enriched uranium will be utilized in nuclear reactor. But I'll come when I'll explain, then you, it will be better for you. When I will explain, then you, it will be clear to you. So according to you, high enriched uranium in atomic bomb, slightly enriched uranium SEU for research education, and in the nuclear reactor there is a low enriched uranium. Perhaps all of your understanding, I need safety. So perhaps this is clear to you. What is the enrichment? Enrichment means increasing the percentage of uranium 235, It is the uranium 235, and there are the process how to enrich. I have utilized the word filter to make you to understand easily. But how to filter, that is the most important, and it is, I said that now convert yellow cake into uranium hexafluoride. This is the first step for enrichment. How to enrich? Listen me carefully. Now, you know that how to enrich. The process is first convert yellow cake in UF6. Do you know that what is the centrifugal force? Centrifugal force means I said that, and centripetal force. Centrifugal force means I said that if I am making something to rotate, then something will try to move away, yes or not? It is rotating. And centrifugal force, if I say that centrifugal force, if I say that it is mv square upon r, the speed through which it is moving, and m. So centrifugal force, we can say that F equals to mv square upon r. It means we can say that who is in the numerator, m and velocity, mass and velocity. It is clear. Mass and centrifugal force means it is a force which is acting away from the center. Perhaps all of you know that. Perhaps centrifugal force, if I said that, away from the center, it wants to move away. Now, one side it is, I said that, is, can we say that F is directly proportional to mass, and F is directly proportional to V square, means centrifugal force is numerator, in the numerator there is an M and V square. It is of general thing, do not, if you understand that only, yadi koi nahi janta hoga, if some of you are not knowing, so only you just try to see that, okay, centrifugal force is mv square upon r. R is the radius into which it is moving. R is the radius into which it is moving. Now, tell me, directly proportional, you know that directly proportional ka matlab kya hota hai? If the mass is increasing, the centrifugal force is more. If the mass is increasing, centrifugal force is more. And if the velocity is more, then the centrifugal force is more. It wants to move away. Yes or not? If the mass is more or velocity, so when do the centrifugal force is more? When the mass is high and then velocity is high. When the mass is low, if the mass is less, then it will feel less centrifugal force. Yes or not? Now my question is, I said that there is, I said that uranium 238, and here it is a uranium 235. Its mass is 235 and its mass is 238. Now my next question, my question is, uranium 238, if both are moving in the same radius and same velocity, who will face more centrifugal force? Who will face more centrifugal force? Uranium 238 or uranium 235? Who will face more centrifugal force? Abhi maine aap logon ko bataya, I have told you, if the mass is higher, more the centrifugal force. If the mass is higher, more the centrifugal force. Is it clear? If the mass is higher, more the centrifugal force. Now, if I am talking about, there is a uranium 238 and a uranium 235. Who will face more centrifugal force and wants to go away? Who will face more centrifugal force and wants to go away? Who will feel more centrifugal force and wants to move away? Clear? So all of you are answering, sir, uranium 238. All of you are answering uranium 238. That's true. Okay? And it is 100% correct that the uranium 238 will feel more centrifugal force because its mass is more. Uranium 238 will feel more centrifugal force because its mass is more. Now, if I say that, suppose there is in a box, suppose I have an, I said that one box is there. One box is there, and in this box, if uranium 238 and uranium 235 is rotating, uranium 238 and uranium 235, I said that in this box there is in a one big chamber like this, and here it is a big chamber, and uranium 238 and uranium 235 is moving. So who will be far and who will be near? If in a chamber uranium 238 and uranium 235 is moving, who will be far, who will be near? If in a chamber, my next question is, if uranium 238 and uranium 235 is rotating in a chamber, then who will be far and who will be near? They are moving, they are and when they are moving, then they have a centrifugal force. So who will be far and who will be near? If in a chamber is there and uranium 238 and uranium 235 is rotating, then who will be far and who will be near? Now tell me everyone, who will be far and who will be near? If uranium 238 and uranium 235 are rotating in a chamber, then who will be far and who will be near? So I think you understand how to filter out. How to filter out uranium 235 and uranium 238, this is the centrifugal. I said that diffusion and centrifugal process, diffusion and centrifugal process separate uranium 238 and uranium 235. And slowly we will increase the percentage of uranium 235. If it will be more number of times it is rotating, then uranium 238 will keep on moving away, and then the near there will be uranium 235 percentage will keep on increasing. So this is the diffusion and centrifugal process. Diffusion and centrifugal means, I said that diffusion jante honge, convert yellow cake into UF6. UF6 is like a gas. मतलब छोटे छोटे particles में. So हमने क्या किया? What is the first thing? I said uranium 230 that it is a yellow cake, that it is in the second mining first process. Second is myling. Myling means crushing and converting into yellow cake. Now yellow cake convert into UF6, that is uranium hexafluoride, and it diffused. Isko hum log kya karte? Diffuse in chamber. Diffuse means in the form of gaseous form, very high speed we enter. Diffuse means with very high speed it enter into the chamber. Diffuse means with very high speed uranium enter into chamber. So when it will be very high speed, the near one, the far one, it will be uranium 238, and near one the concentration and percentage of uranium 235 will increase. So the what is the process to separate? So the process to separate and enrichment means increasing the percentage of uranium 235. Enrichment means increasing the percentage. Perhaps you know that filtering means If you'll make more number of rotation, uranium 235 will be more near and uranium 230 will be more outer. So the percentage of uranium 235 in a particular region will increase, and this way we'll take it out. So percentage of uranium 235, that is, we have to first process what we have to myelin means converting into yellow cake, and then in the enrichment yellow cake convert into uranium hexafluoride, and this uranium hexafluoride, what happens, it is, and this UF6 diffuse means moving faster speed, moving inside the chamber with faster speed, diffused into chamber, diffused into chamber. When it diffused into the chamber and it start moving very fast, then which role comes? Centrifugal force, and this centrifugal force will separate uranium 238 and uranium 235. Clear? So this is the enrichment, and there are slowly and slowly several times we will do, several times we will do filtering out uranium 235 and uranium 238. So the reason I said perhaps this point is very much clear to all of you. So enrichment means increasing the percentage of uranium 235, there is a slightly enriched uranium SEU, and 1 to 3%, low enriched uranium is 3 to 20%, and highly enriched uranium 20 to 80%. My next question, India uses enrichment process? Answer is no, because no, India does not use enrichment process because it is very costly. He utilizes some other process, and it is a smart process utilized. Because enrichment that you have been able to see, okay, it is separating this, it is becoming, I said that one thing I will say, that just remember later on this process will, this point will come, ki India uses or not. India does not use enrichment. Little bit enrichment India does, but actually the reason I said that whatever it is, India does not have such kind of what enrichment process. Very few enrichment processes are that chambers are there in India, but generally India does not use because it is very, very, very costly. So, but because we do not have such a better technology, the United States, Russia, they have a better technology of enrichment, and that it is, when I will become the member of NSG, nuclear supplier group, perhaps that technology we can be able to take. But India doesn't have, I said that does not use this enrichment process. But it is, what is the need of converting? Again, you are asking the question which is not required. Uranium is U3O8, and it has to convert into EF6. There is some chemical process. What is the use? You just tell me. If I am teaching something, please stick with the, from the first day I am telling you, beta. There is no need to know the chemistry of it. Where there is some chemistry reaction is needed, there I explain it is the uranium to neutron, uranium 235, barium, krypton and all. Here it is not required. If I am not telling, means not required, beta. Now just keep on, no need to go for it, don't be so accusative. Don't have such an curiosity, because it will kill your approach for UPSC. Curiosity is good, but you should now start understanding, Pankaj sir is not teaching, it means it is not required. Just let me go ahead, if it is required I will tell you, if it is not required I will not tell you. Itna to bharosa ho gaya, perhaps this kind of faith you have. I'll tell you, beta, just wait, I'm going. Are you here? Why am I sitting? Tell me, to teach you, na beta, and I'm trying to teach you better. कॉफी बोल देना, कॉफी. ऑल ऑफ यू आर गेटिंग माई पॉइंट. इफ यू स्टार्ट आस्किंग सच क्वेश्चन, माई मोमेंटम यू नो दैट ब्रेक्स. एवरी वन हु इज सिटिंग एंड स्टडिंग विद मी मस्ट बी एंजॉइंग माई क्लास. But what is the meaning of this if you are not understanding my request? Just wait, beta. At the end, if you have an query, then it will be clear. I'll make it clear. And possibly I never try to make your query not to be solved. I have a great respect to all of you, great, really mean great respect to all of you. A teacher respects to you, then you should also respect the teacher. Allow her, if you have seen, okay, if I am teaching good to you, then if I don't know whether you say what, if I am teaching good to you, then you should wait. Sir will not leave. He will give most of the things which is required and most of the concept which you need. So I said, India, that I can say right now, it is in a very, India doesn't have such technology. Anything become costly when you don't have the better technology. India doesn't have that technology, and therefore it is becoming very costly. And India cannot take this technology from the any country of the world, because India is not a member of NSG, Nuclear Supplier Group. India did not sign NPT. Ye sab abhi bata bhi nahi sakta. Main itna hi isliye, therefore I am saying, only that much I can say that India is not using this process because it is costly. But India, you know that he knows what to do. He has India is a jugadu kind of, I said, that country. And it's not jugadu, the best technology kind of jugadu. On the basis of their availability resources, he does something better, India does something better. And India has done better than this. Let me teach. So India uses, I said that India uses enrichment process, perhaps India uses enrichment process, no. This is a question mark here. India uses enrichment process, no, because it is very costly, that much I can say. Clear to you? Next point, I said that what are the things we have seen in the nuclear fuel cycle. I said that first it is mining. Second one, I said that mining is already clear to you. Mining means crushing the uranium into powder and then converting into a cake, that is known as yellow cake. And further in the enrichment we have seen, the next one is enrichment, and then enrichment means I said that increasing the percentage of uranium 235 with the help of diffusion and centrifugal force enrichment. There are the three types of enrichment. I said that first it is slightly enriched uranium, and here we have 1% to 3%. What is the use of it? What is the use of this slightly enriched uranium? If I am talking about, we can treat cancer, means it is in the medical sector. Yes, in the university there is a very less amount of uranium enriched, otherwise it will be disastrous to use it. So research, doing research with the uranium and further how to improve the nuclear technology, so we should experiment with, I said that, slightly enriched uranium. So the research is there. In research, university, etcetera, clear, it should be utilized. Now, do you know that in our agriculture sector, farmer is producing grains. Thereafter, it has been sold into the, I said that, in the market at some prices. And then government of India, or maybe I said the other sector, those procured it on the basis of some procurement price or some other prices, and thereafter it goes into a particular, I said that, where I said those grains are, I said, kept. In Food Corporation of India. So, Food Corporation of India, so after purchasing it from the market, then it goes into the Food Corporation of India, and they make in a storage. So, this is in a storage, and thereafter it goes into the market through the PDS system, public distribution system, to the, I said that, below poverty line people and other section. So here it is, this food is kept in the FCI stored, and this FCI, now I am talking about this Food Corporation of India, here the stored grains, but this one they started, I said that, affected by bacteria and fungi. And out of this total stored, one third become unusable. Suppose there is an 100 kg of grain are kept in the Food Corporation of India, stored in that region, then slowly and slowly bacteria and fungi, and this season of, I said that, monsoonal season, rainy season, also help in growth of more bacteria and fungi, which keeps on pathogens, which keep on deteriorating the grains, and the one third is there. Killer. Then what should I do? I'll say that here it is very, I said it, this is the Food Corporation of India, and here it is, grains are kept and stored. Then there will be, I'll put some radiation, and radiation will kill. I said that bacteria, radiation will kill bacteria, fungi. And this way we have done, I said that secured the food. I should know that how much radiation of, I said that how much radiation is there. High radiation means it will be contaminated and we can't eat. It is also there. I should not do high amount of radiation. I should not do high amount of, I said that radiation. So we can, in the, I said that we can do something in the field of agriculture. We can also perhaps in the biotechnology, suppose I said that in biotechnology one word is there, like suppose there is an rice, and rice has more carbohydrate, more starch, that is, and protein is not. Protein is not available in the rice. This is your rice grain. This is the rice grain. Understood? So what I'll do, this is the rice grain, and here I have one fish, and fish has good, I said that protein, or maybe you know that pulse jante hoge, pulse has also good protein. They have a protein. And then rice does not protein. They does not have protein. So what I'll do, I'll take the DNA of this is the DNA of rice, and I have taken the DNA abhi aap itna hi samjhe, deoxyribic nucleic acid, it is a protein, DNA. The DNA it is not, it is a genetic structure. So here it is a DNA of, it is a pulse. And what I did, I have cut the DNA of this one, and I took it from here and then combined it in the rice. So the DNA of simple idea I am just giving, DNA of pulse has been combined with DNA of rice. Now thereafter there is a new variety of rice will come, where there is a carbohydrate plus protein, there is a carbohydrate and also there is a protein. And this is known as a genetic engineering, or better to say genetically modified organism. And we have done something, biotechnology means biotechnologically we developed some better quality of rice. And this is known as genetic engineering. That you have to study during the biotechnology in a very, I said that, expanded form. So just I am talking about, if I have a rice DNA and I am doing radiation, I am giving some radiation, I can change the character of rice. Means genetic engineering can change the character of rice. Character of rice means I can change in the DNA structure of rice, and possibly generally rice takes 3 months to grow, it start growing in 2 months. So if the monsoon and the summer is of 4 months, so I can do rice 2 months once, and again I can sow the rice, and again I can grow and cut the, so we can increase the agricultural productivity. I can, through the radiation, I said that we can change the character of rice, that is the DNA structure of rice, and possibly its maturity period is, if the rice maturity period is 3 months, I will reduce the maturity period 2 months, and it can, we, and then in the 4 months, the generally rice is producing once, in 4 months now I can produce twice. It means agriculture productivity has increased. This way I can change several other character also. It means it is not only storing in the food, but it is also helping in genetic engineering of the, I said that, agriculture sector. So you can be able to see, like I said, that this is a SEU is helping treatment of cancer, medical sector, research. It is, I said, that storing grains, and I said that storing grains, we can say that, and also we can say that it is an agriculture sector boom. Means productivity can increase, and the several things can be done. To slightly enrich uranium, it is in a treating the cancer research, and we can also use for research reactor. Reactor, you know that it is production of electricity. These points must be clear. Cancer, that is in the medical sector, different way, research, university. Suppose I have to sanitize several. Suppose from the USA, I have brought several medical equipment in India, medical equipment in India, and it is coming into the, it is in India hospital, and this is the corona period. Then before coming into those medical, it is not through the sanitizer, we have to sanitize. I'll keep it in a particular chamber, and radiation will give, there is an all the organism, that it is, I said, then microorganism and all the things will be removed, and it is a sanitize. It is a large scale sanitized to the product, but it is at a very slightly enriched uranium, 1%, 1.5% uranium, 235. Another, so the sharing, it is in a storing grains, you have been understand, agriculture sector boom, you understood, and research reactors, means one nuclear reactor where it is, I said that, which is helping in production of electricity, but the research reactor, here the reactor is there, but it is not producing electricity, but the people are, the scientists are doing research. This research is in the university, but this research is, it is a nuclear reactor. Produces zero energy. Zero energy. It means if it is producing zero energy, therefore it is also known as zero reactor. But it help in scientific research. So the research reactor, what is the function of research reactor? That it is a nuclear reactor. What is the meaning of research reactor? It is a reactor, nuclear reactor, but it does not produce electricity. It does not produce electricity, it means zero reactor. Research reactor is a zero reactor, but it is also helping if I have to do something like I have to make one nuclear reactor, and a high quality nuclear reactor. Before that, making such a nuclear reactor, I have to do some research. If you go to the Mumbai, there is in a Trombay, Tarapur, and there are several research reactors are there. Purnima 1, Purnima 2, Purnima, Cyrus, Jarlina, different types of research reactors are there. And these research reactors are not producing electricity, but it is helping in the, I said that, further growth of India's nuclear reactor. So research ka matlab jante ho na, it is helping to give in something better, and we'll produce better technology. and we'll do research with the help of which uranium? Slightly enriched uranium. So what is the job of slightly enriched uranium? I said that it is in a 1-2-3% uranium 235, it treated cancer, research in university, storing grains, agriculture sector boom, research reactors, and these are the things which is here. So this is, I said, that slightly enriched uranium. Perhaps it is clear to all of you, SEU. And the next one it is two to four sentences if we have to write about the enrichment. That is, you can easily write enrichment means it is the increasing the percentage of uranium 235, especially from the natural uranium. What is the natural uranium? Where the 99.3% is your uranium 238 and 0.7% is uranium 235. So, aap likhoge, natural uranium is in the form of 99.3% uranium 238 and uranium 235 as a 0.7%. To increase the percentage of uranium 235, again I said that natural uranium has 99.3% uranium 238 and 0.7% uranium 235. To increase the percentage of uranium 235, there is in a process of diffusion and centrifugal process involved after converting yellow cake into UF6. Tabhi to hum log karte hain. And then this whole process is known as enrichment. And there are the three category of enrichment. First is slightly enriched uranium, and write about it is 1-3%, and write something about it. There is in a low enriched uranium, there is in a 3-20%, write about it. And then high enriched uranium, write about it. This is the way. You will not be able to write 2-4%. You can be able to write 10 lines, 15 lines. Next one, I said that there is a low enriched uranium. And that is, I said that 3-20% U-235. And it is utilized in nuclear reactor. And you know that it is in a producing electricity, nuclear reactor. Another, we have to make nuclear weapons. If I have to utilize something in the BrahMos 1, in the Nirbhaya, these are the Nirbhaya. Somewhere in any missile, if I have to utilize, that will not be in a highly enriched uranium, atomic bomb like not, but it is in like in a weapon, nuclear weapons, not atomic bomb I am talking about. Atomic bomb like that kind of concept will be utilized in the Agni 1, Agni 2, Agni 3, Agni 4, Agni 5, Agni 6. They will take very heavy, means atomic bomb kind of nuclear device. But in the other missiles, there will be a nuclear weapons, means it is not highly enriched uranium. So there will be, it is in a, I said the nuclear weapon formation. Okay, so what is the use of low enriched uranium? It is, I said that nuclear reactor. And what is the meaning of reactor? It is producing what? Electricity. And what is the meaning of this? Peaceful use of energy. Peaceful use of nuclear. Log bolte hai na, what is the peaceful use of nuclear? Slightly enriched uranium is a peaceful use of nuclear. Low enriched uranium, it is the purpose for, I said that, peaceful means producing electricity. producing what? Electricity. Clear about low enriched uranium? So the low enriched uranium is 3 to 20% uranium-235, and nuclear reactor, it is utilized in the nuclear reactor for the production of electricity, and it means it is a peaceful use of it energy, and it is a nuclear weapon formation. Next one, it is HU, highly enriched uranium, and it is, I said that 20 to 80%. 20 to 80%. And here it will be, if it is a 70%, 80%, 85%, 95%, so the different quality of atomic bomb forms. Even it goes to 85, 95%, these are utilized in making atomic bomb. Clear? Atomic bomb. So we have seen slightly enriched uranium, it is in the research, in the education, in the universities research, in the different medical sector, in the Food Corporation of India for storing aspect, agricultural sector boom, and then research reactor, where there is a reactor, nuclear reactor is there, but it is not producing electricity. For it is for the scientific, and it is for the research of scientists are doing research there, and scientific experiments are going on. And then low enriched uranium, I said that, and that is also peaceful use. Slightly enriched uranium is a completely peaceful use of nuclear technology. Somebody said that nuclear technology means, I said that atomic bomb, but there is a great use, I said that in this sector. Next one, I said that low enriched uranium, it is a nuclear reactor, and it is, I said that, forming of nuclear weapons. And here it is in a highly enriched uranium, it is, I said that, atomic bomb. The quality of atomic bomb will be better and better when the percentage of uranium-235 is very high and high. So perhaps you have been able to understand what is it. Clear? So I was thinking one question, and but I have forgotten. My next question, that it is now, next it is, perhaps this point is completely okay to all of you. Enrichment. My next point it is, we have to see like, and the fourth point is reprocessing. First is mining, second is milling. M-I-N-I-G mining first, second milling, M-I-L-L-I-N-G milling means crushing and the converting into yellow cake, and the third is enrichment, and you have been understood enrichment. Clear? Now my question to all of you, India is not a member of NSG. Everyone listen me carefully. India is not a member of nuclear supplier group. Everyone listen me carefully. India is not a member of nuclear supplier group. And India is taking nuclear fuel from the other country. So which nuclear fuel the other country will give to India? Just give your thought. slightly enriched uranium, low enriched uranium, high enriched uranium. It can be one or two or any three types. India is not a member of NSG, and the world does not want that any other country, tomorrow wo bahut sari clear hongi, any other country should not have nuclear weapons. And I said that they should not have grow the nuclear weapons, they should not grow atomic bomb. NSG does not want that country, other countries should not accept USA, Russia, France, UK and China. Other countries should not produce nuclear weapon and atomic bomb. And if India is not a member of NSG, then which enriched uranium India is importing from the other? Which enriched? Again, I am telling you, listen me carefully, India is not a member of NSG, then which enriched uranium that India can import? Yes. Very good, very good, Mr. Rishabh. Yes, India will be able to import, I said that first SEU, slightly enriched uranium. Second, India will also be able to import LEU, low enriched uranium, where it is which can help in producing electricity in the nuclear reactor. But there will be some limit in LEU, low enriched uranium, there will be some limit so that the India should not be able to make nuclear weapon. Perhaps it is clear, SEU and LEU, but LEU there will be some limit, because LEU can also produce weapons. That's okay, yeah. HEU will make atomic bomb. HEU will make atomic bomb and very high level of nuclear weapon. HEU, highly enriched uranium, that is 20 to 80% atomic bomb and even more. It is also high quality of nuclear weapon. But in LEU, that is mostly of nuclear reactor, but there is an also probability to make, nuclear weapons. So there should be some limitation in giving LEU. Perhaps it is clear to all of you that India is, can India take nuclear technology? Can India import nuclear technology if India is not a member of NSG? Yes or no? Can India import nuclear technology if India is not a member of NSG? Can India import nuclear technology if India is not a member? Just I am connecting beta because I am thinking you can answer. Just I am connecting because you understanding that okay, these are the processes. India is not a member, then the nobody will give the technology. Can, then can you say that you all of you have said that no, sir? And no is correct. No nuclear technology can be imported by India. No nuclear technology can be imported by India. I think from tomorrow onwards and after that, you will enjoy up to the greatest level because you started correlating with the international relations in the field of nuclear technology. When you start correlating, then you start understanding what is the role of several things. And therefore, India is fighting that I should become the member of NSG, but only China is stopping. I'll take it later on. This topic I am not taking right now, NPT, NSG, it will be later on. That time I'll do the detailing. Just I am relating you that India is not a member of NSG, then he cannot, he can import, I said that SEU and LEU, but with some limit, with some limit, and import nuclear technology not at all, import nuclear technology not at all. Can India, my next question is, can India import enrichment technology? Can India import enrichment technology? High level of sophisticated enrichment technology? Can India import high level of, this is very sophisticated, very important enrichment technology. India can import this enrichment technology? If India cannot import nuclear technology, how can he import it? Enrichment? Enrichment is a nuclear technology. No country, neither US nor France, they will not give. Wo later on samajh mein aayega ki kya de sakta hai, kya nahi de sakta hai. There is a one point it will also come NSG waiver. Perhaps all of you understand, India cannot import any enrichment technology since India is not a member of NSG. So, no, right now no, beta, I can say, this is, I said that enrichment, yadi aap India ne enrichment le liya, toh kya banayega? Tell me, if India is having nuclear, if India is having enrichment technology, then India can produce HEU. India can easily produce HEU with the enrichment. He can make highly enriched uranium and then he can start producing atomic bomb. Clear? So perhaps it is clear that I have given idea about enrichment. Enrichment is a process of increasing the percentage of uranium 235 with the help of process of diffusion and centrifugal process, and where UF6 is diffused and it is, I said that converting into slightly enriched uranium SEU, SEU 1 to 3%, LEU it is 3 to 20%, and HEU 20 to 80%. Some books are writing different percentages. Okay, you should not worry about, sir, this percentage in this one it is mentioned, this one it is mentioned, this one. You should not worry, it is, you should go for with the, go with this. Now the my point of view, you are going to enjoy the next level, and this is a reprocessing, and you will be highly happy. This is our chamber, listen me carefully, this is our chamber, and here we have, I said that uranium rod, and you remember there it is thousands of uranium rod. I am just making 1, 2, 3, but it is, there is a thousands of, there is, I said that beta, thoda sa cool and calm, here it is, I said, this is, I said that uranium rod. And this is the chamber. And in this one, there is, I said, and in this one, there are the two things are there, uranium 238 and uranium 235. In the uranium rod, beta, heavy water concept will come later on. Why you are writing something like this, beta? When I'll do the different reactors, then the you can understand this topic. I don't want to get into the heavy water. Right now, only we are in the nuclear fuel cycle. Beta, don't get into this heavy water right now, because you are again changing your concept. I said that when I'll do the different types of, India has a pressurized heavy water reactor, India has, and I said that thermal fast breeder reactor, India has, I said that advanced heavy water reactor. Abhi ruko to sahi, it will be tomorrow, it will come. Don't ask these questions. Just go for it. Do not move ahead, beta Samir. Just wait. Here I am, I have to do the next topic. It is about reprocessing, fourth process. Just study as I am teaching you, because it will help you to grab the understanding. What is in the chamber, uranium 235 and uranium 238, yes or not? If I say that, listen me, if this is a chamber and a uranium 235 is bombarding with neutrons, so it is giving us what? Neutron also. It is giving us what I said, that barium, krypton and energy and 3 neutrons. And it may say out of these 3 neutrons, I have to control 2 neutrons or 1 neutron with the help of controlling rod. Do you know that in the chamber, what are the two things there? U-235 and uranium-238. Is it clear? In nuclear reactor, if I have any kind of, I said uranium, if any kind of uranium, the U-235, listen me carefully, and there will be uranium U-238. So, with the help of neutron bombardment, uranium 235 will, what I said, disintegrate into barium, krypton and then energy and 3 neutrons, yes or not? And out of the 3 neutrons, some neutrons will be, what I said, that absorbed. Clear? Listen me carefully, but uranium 238 will not disintegrate. Uranium 238 will not disintegrate, but it can absorb neutron, because the 3 neutrons are there, and the sum of the neutron will be absorbed by uranium 238, and the energy will be in the form of beta decay, gamma decay. So there will be also beta decay. So this uranium 238 will transmute into change into plutonium 239. In the chamber I have uranium 235 and in the chamber I have uranium 238, because in the rod there will be some percentage of uranium 235, suppose LEU 3 to 20%, and the rest is uranium 238. Rest is what? Uranium 238. So uranium 235 will give energy and neutrons, and energy, alpha decay, beta decay, radiations, there will be lots of radiations. So these radiations and neutron will change uranium-238, which is in a fertile material, converting into plutonium. And at the end, what I will get? Listen me carefully. I will get plutonium-239 and some barium and krypton. And something uranium-238. Some of the uranium-238 will not be. So, at the end of nuclear reactor, jaise nuclear mein humne dal diya, perhaps you are getting my point. Listen me carefully. What are the two things in the nuclear reactor? LEU. LEU. What is the meaning of it? There will be, suppose there will be uranium-235 will be 3 to 20%, and there will be, I said that suppose uranium-238. So in the chamber both are there, it will give energy and neutron also released. This neutron will be absorbed by uranium-238 and beta decay, it will convert into plutonium-239. It means I am getting fissionable material. Yahi Bharat kar raha hai, India is doing this. In his nuclear reactor, he is making also fissionable material plutonium-239. And it is the character of India. Other countries have not this kind of technology. India is doing this. He is making uranium-238 in the chamber, in the nuclear reactor itself, converting into plutonium-239. This is India I am talking about. Other countries, very less countries are doing, and it is with the help of pressurized heavy water reactor, I will tell you later on. So in the chamber, I can convert, jo hamare liye kachada tha, this is then a waste. Uranium-238 is not giving energy, but I am converting it into plutonium-239. Are maza aa raha, all of you are enjoying. This is India. We are producing uranium-235 energy is producing electricity and all. But what about uranium-238? India is able to convert uranium-238 into plutonium-239 in the nuclear reactor itself. All of you are getting in the nuclear reactor uranium-235 is converting into energy. But what about uranium-238? It will not disintegrate. Then what happened? By absorbing neutron and some radiation, it is converting into plutonium-239. This is the achievement of India. He does not need any enrichment process. Bolta hai, tum mere ko kuch bhi de do, main apne chamber mein hi, I will convert. Give me any uranium. In the chamber, he is converting uranium-238 into plutonium-239. And plutonium-239, you know that it is in a what? Fissionable material. This is the quality of India. This is the, in our India, tomorrow when I will discuss about it, you will start understanding, these are the different types of reactor India is having. And this is the method that India has adopted and it was given by Homi Jahangir Baba. So, I said that what I will get, one side I said that we have used, and another it is I said that fissionable. And one side we have what I said that barium and krypton. So we have, I said that we have some uranium-238 which is not converted into plutonium-239. Some we have got plutonium and we are able to get plutonium-239 and this is your waste. So from the reactor we will be able to get three things. At the end of the reactors we will get plutonium-239. And the uranium-235 converted into barium and krypton, and that is in a waste. and uranium-238, some of the uranium-238 has not been converted. So these are, and then separation of fissionable material used and waste material. This is known as reprocessing, and India is the topmost in the world in reprocessing. What the India is doing? I said that what is the meaning of reprocessing? Reprocessing means separating fissionable, unused. Which one is unused? This uranium-230 is not used. It is unused. It is not able to disintegrate into plutonium-239. It is unused. So separating fissionable, unused, and waste material. नहीं बेटा, अभी वो तुरंत रिएक्टर नहीं करते हैं. हर एक का, एवरी वन रिक्वायर्स डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ वेलोसिटी ऑफ न्यूट्रॉन. प्लूटोनियम 239 विल नॉट डिसइंटीग्रेट इनटू एनर्जी बिकॉज इट इज नाउ कन्वर्टिंग इनटू, बिकॉज देयर इज अ नीड ऑफ सम डिफरेंट स्पीड. क्लियर? यूरेनियम 235 डिसइंटीग्रेशन नीड्स समथिंग, प्लूटोनियम 239 नीड्स सम अदर स्पीड. So we are able to get plutonium-239, some that is fissionable and used and waste material. That pre-processing is this method. Are, this is the question by Pakistan. Abhi just wait beta, they are not watching my video. It is everyone knows. When I'll teach, let me go for next 2 days at least, then you will be able to know more better. Clear? So I said that reprocessing means separation and fuel fabrication. So what are the their few in the nuclear fuel cycle? There is a first method is mining, second method is mining, already you know that, extracting uranium from the mines. Mining means crushing the uranium ore into powder and converting into yellow cake, mining. Thereafter we have seen enrichment, and I said that enrichment, there are the increasing the percentage of uranium-235 through the process of diffusion and centrifugal. And first we converted yellow cake into uranium hexafluoride UF6, and there are the SEU 1 to 3%, LEU 3 to 20%, and HEU highly enriched uranium 20 to 80%, and we have seen some application of it. And thereafter reprocessing means I said that separating fissionable material, waste material and unused. Clear? And the next one is fuel fabrication. Fuel fabrication means, I said that fuel fabrication making uranium rod. With the help of uranium oxide. Simple fuel fabrication means making uranium rod. Fissionable, you know that I have taken earlier, fissionables are uranium-233, uranium-235, plutonium-239, plutonium-241. These are the fissionable. Fertile are I talked to you that it is uranium-238 is fertile and thorium-232. I have discussed everything earlier. So uranium-233, uranium-235, plutonium-239 and plutonium-241, they are fissionable. Clear? So fuel fabrication means making uranium rod, the process of making uranium rod. So process of making uranium rod with the help of uranium oxide. So there is five processes are involved: mining, second milling, third enrichment, fourth pre-processing, fifth it is, I said that, fuel fabrication. Perhaps nuclear fuel cycle is clear to all of you. Beta, genetic engineering is, I said that, in the biotechnology section it will be clear. Abhi itna hi keh sakta hu, that much it will be genetic engineering. I can say that suppose rice by the time everything is clear, beta. Yes, some of the it's not like that every uranium-238 will be converted into plutonium-239. Some are still unused. Clear? All of you understood and enjoyed, beta? All of you understood this, all the things I talked about, mining, milling, enrichment, reprocessing, the separation, and I said that fuel fabrication. All of you enjoyed, beta? Yes, we can use in genetic engineering, beta. We can use genetic engineering slightly enriched uranium. Slightly enriched uranium. If I say that what is genetic engineering, thoda sa main, one student was asking, do you know that there is a cotton plant? Suppose I said that there is a cotton plant is there, and generally what happens, the cotton has a green plant, green leaves they have. I said that green leaves, cotton has a green leaves, and this green leaves with the help of photosynthesis makes food, and if there is a more photosynthesis, there will be more cotton production. In Maharashtra and Gujarat, what we can say that cotton will produce high productivity, cotton will be in high productivity when there is, I said that leaves are there, and these leaves are properly all around, and it is able to absorb the sunlight, and with the help of photosynthesis it is making food, and if it, the plant has good amount of food, then it will give a better cotton and high amount of cotton. But what happens generally, this is, I said that this one is this is the leaf, and this leaves has, I said that, green leaves, but there is some worms are there, they start eating the green leaves, they start eating the green leaves, and if the green leaves are decreasing, means I said that some of the area hole has become, then formation of food by the cotton plant reduces. Clear? Cotton plant stopped their production of food is less because there are several holes in the leaves. There are several holes in the leaves, and that has been made by some worms. They have eaten the leaves of the cotton plant, and the less photosynthesis, less food. So what happened? Then what happened? There is I said that Bacillus thuringiensis. ये जो है दिस इज द नाउ वॉर्म स्पेसिस, वॉर्म स्पेसिस, दीज आर द वॉर्म स्पेसिस, दोज हु आर ईटिंग दिस प्लांट लीव्स, बेटा अभी तो एनएसजी जब आएगा देन आई डिस्कस, बेटा एनएसजी आएगा तब डिस्कस करेंगे उसके बारे में. नाउ I said that, listen me, here it is. So I have one worm, and it is what? BT, Bacillus thuringiensis, and we have a cotton plant, and there is a cotton seed. So I have taken the DNA of cotton, and there is a DNA of this worm, and I am cutting it from here, and I am cutting it from here and joined it here. So the DNA of, so there is a DNA of plant plus there is a DNA of worm. So now the plant cotton seed will have, this cotton seed is now known as BT cotton. So what happened? There is a worm DNA, BT, Bacillus thuringiensis, and there is a cotton DNA. So this is known as a BT cotton. Now just if you can understand then it's okay, don't understand then even then it's okay, because it will be taught in your biotechnology class. So if it is, I said that now we have a new quality of seed, and that is known as a BT cotton. Now this seed will grow, and there is, I said that there is leaves are coming. Leaves are coming. This is, I said that leaves are coming. Now again worm came and he started eating the leaves. But inside the leaf there is a DNA of that worm. Inside the leaf there is a DNA of, because it is a BT cotton, so he will, this worm will not be able to eat, and he will die, or it will die and fall down. So now you can be able to see now that the leaves are proper, and then good amount of photosynthesis and good amount of cotton production. So it is known as what? Genetic engineering. So genetic engineering, thoda sa aapko idea keval diya. Better don't get into it, it is a topic of biotechnology. It is not the topic of, just one student was asking ki what is genetic engineering. Genetic engineering mein yehi karna hota hai ki two different DNA has to be recombined. Two different DNA of two different species has to be recombined to give a new species. Genetic engineering. So beta, reprocessing is little tougher. I'll explain it tomorrow, because when I'll come into those section then it will be, I'll make it clear over there. Okay, if your internet is not working at that time, I'll make it tomorrow. Beta, Kalam sir has a different approach. A
SEU, genetic engineering, I said that he will change the DNA and DNA will be, I said that particular DNA will be lost. If I am giving the radiation, particular DNA will be lost and we can also recombine some DNA of others. We can combine the DNA of others with the help of radiation and remove something and then adding it. So, tomorrow we have finished with, I said that total today, I said I have given the idea of, what are the components of nuclear reactor. It is moderator, which I said that water, heavy water and graphite, and then I discuss about what are the components. It is a coolant, it is an also water, heavy water, and I said that gases and liquid sodium metal. So, they can exchange the heat, yes or not, coolant, and there is a control rod that absorbs the neutron, and these are Bossy, India, yaad hoga, control karte hain, Bossy, boron, silver, indium and cadmium. These are, I said, the control rods, and thereafter we have seen there is a shielding, and that the concrete shield should be of thick of 2 meter to 2.25 meter like this. And then we have seen turbine. It is the turbine one is converting heat energy into mechanical energy, and we have you know that generator which is producing electricity. And after doing this component of nuclear reactors, we have seen the nuclear fuel cycle, mining, myling, enrichment, three types of enrichment we have seen, reprocessing means separation of fissionable material, unused material and waste material. And then we have seen fuel fabrication means making nuclear rod with the help of uranium oxide. Simple, in a pipe, in a steel pipe generally we mix, in the steel pipe we used to make a uranium rods, in that one particular with the help of uranium oxide, that much you should know. Yes, beta, everywhere genetic engineering is very important. So, we have finished with all this. All of you understand, so that we can say good night. It will take beta by the Friday, it will get complete. 3 days more it requires. 3 days or you want to finish it fast? No need, beta. Priya, it will take 3 or 4 days more. Nuclear technology will take 3 or 4 days more, beta. I am not getting your question, Priya. What do you want to ask? Good night, beta. Good night, everyone. What is your question, Priya? Thanks to all of you, beta. Thanks. Beta, I am doing with my own space. My pace is, I know that how to complete. I know that how much time it will take. It's not about that. I never in the hurry. I just take whenever it will get complete, that day it will complete. what are the things you need, that I will make you to do. I will not do like you should become the engineer in nuclear technology. I don't want to do anything like space technology that you should become the engineer in that one. I am doing as per the requirement of civil services. Thank you, beta. So we'll meet tomorrow, and till then, good night.